Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create your own custom playing card adorned with a monogram design of your initials. This tutorial is in two parts. In part one, we'll create our basic playing card, and in part two, we'll add the face design and monogram. I provided this Photoshop template so you can follow along. Its link is located in the video's description below or the project files. Go to View and make sure Snap is checked. If it isn't, just click on it. Go to Show and make sure Guides is checked as well. Open your gradient tool. At the top, make sure the linear gradient icon is active. Click the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. Click the black to white third gradient on the top and click the lower right stop. Click the color box and in the hexadecimal field, type in 152A04. Then press enter or return twice to close both windows. Go to the top of the document and press and hold Shift as you drag down the gradient tool to the bottom. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer and name it Card Shape. Open your Rounded Rectangle tool and click Shape. If you're using CS5 or earlier, the Shape icon is here. Click the Fill box and pick White. We won't be using a stroke, so make sure Stroke has this icon next to it. Make its radius 80 pixels and click the gear icon. Tick Unconstrained and make sure From Center is not checked. Go to the top left corner of the guideline and drag out a shape to the lower right corner. Then release. It'll snap in place because we have snap checked. If a window pops up before you can even drag your tool, try it again, but this time, just press and hold your mouse or pen as you immediately drag your tool. Make a new layer and name it Outline. Open your rectangular marquee tool. Go to the top left corner again and drag a selection to the opposite corner. Go to Select and Transform Selection. In the Width field, type in 67% and in the Height field, type in 81%. Then press Enter or Return. Go to Edit and Stroke. Make the stroke 7 pixels, the color is black, and the location is inside. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. Open your horizontal type tool. I'm using a font called Card Character Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. Make its size 30 points, smooth, and center alignment. Click the color box. If your card suit is clubs or spades, pick black. If your card suit is diamonds or hearts, pick red. For my red, I'll type in the hexadecimal field DF1128. Click on the middle of the guideline and type out the letter or number of your card. Open your custom shape tool. Open your current shapes and click the gear icon in the panel. Click Shapes and click OK to replace the current shapes with the new shapes. I'll click this heart shape, however, you can also click the diamond, club, or spade. Click the gear icon at the top and tick Define Proportions and check From Center. Click on the center of the guideline below your letter or number and drag out the shape. To slide it up or down, open your Move tool and press the up or down arrow on your keyboard. Merge your number or letter with the shape of the suit. To do this, shift-click the text layer to make it active as well, and press Ctrl or Command E. Then, name the layer. Drag it to the upper left area. To slide it to the left or right, press the left or right arrow key on your keyboard. To copy it to the lower right corner, press Ctrl or Command A to select your document's dimensions and go to Edit, Transform, and Rotate 180 degrees. Then, deselect it. Merge the two top layers by pressing Ctrl or Command E. Make a new layer and name it Inside Plate. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool, go to the upper left corner of the guideline, and drag down a selection to the lower right corner. Go to Select and Transform Selection. For the width, type in 60%, and for the height, type in 75%. Then click the check mark at the top. We'll fill the selection with black. Make your foreground color black by pressing D on your keyboard or by clicking this icon. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill it with a foreground color. Then deselect it. Double-click the thumbnail of the inside plate to open the Layer Style window. Click Color Overlay and the Color box. Pick a color. You can always change it later. Since I already know the color I want, I'll type it in. Once you pick your color, click OK or press Enter or Return. Click Stroke and the Color box. Then pick a color for the stroke. Make the position inside and the size 14 pixels. For now, I'll make its opacity between 60 to 65%. In part 2, we'll complete our playing card with a custom monogram design of your initials integrated with intricate background graphics. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.